Hello everyone. Good morning everybody. Welcome back to the class of chemistry. I am Ayushi Sharma, your chemistry teacher. So today I am going to discuss one more topic for revision, that is the existence of atoms in two forms. And the two forms are molecules and ions. Yes, as we know that atoms exist in two forms, as molecules and as ions. So let's begin with today's class and understand the topic in a better way. When we talk about atoms, we know that most of the atoms are very very reactive in nature, and they do not present or exist in the free state, or we can say that they cannot exist as a single atom. They always present in the combined state, and this combined state is known as molecules. When we talk about some of the elements like noble gases, example helium, argon, neon, krypton, etc. So the atom of these noble gases exist as single atom, because we know that these noble gases are very unreactive in nature. When we talk about molecules, we know that molecules are formed when two or more than two elements combine together. On the basis of the elements, whether same elements or different elements combine together, we are having two types of molecules. The very first, we are having molecules of elements. The molecules of elements are formed when the atoms of same elements combine together. For example, hydrogen, H2. In this molecule, two atoms of hydrogen combine together chemically and forms a molecule of hydrogen. The next we are having molecules of compounds. When we talk about molecules of compound, it means the atoms of different elements combine together chemically, right? Now, the second form in which atom exists is known as ions. When we talk about ions, these ions are the charged particles which are formed when an atom loses or gains some electrons, right? So these ions are of two types, that is cations and anions. We will be discussing these two types of ions later on. Let's begin with our topic, molecules of elements, in detail. First of all, we will be discussing about the molecules of elements. The molecules of elements defined as the substance which contain two or more similar atoms which are chemically combined together. For example, a molecule of hydrogen element which contains two hydrogen atoms combined together, and it is written as H2. Okay, the nitrogen gas exists as N2 molecule, oxygen gas exists as O2 molecule, and chlorine gas again exists as Cl2 molecule. We are having some more example like ozone, which existing as O3 molecule, in which three atoms of oxygen combine together chemically, right? On the basis of the number of atoms present in a molecule, we define the term atomicity. Yes, the term atomicity means the number of atoms present in one molecule of an element. For example, the first we are having monoatomic. Mono means one. The molecule in which only one atom of the same element present. For example, different metals like sodium, magnesium, aluminium, copper, iron, and some noble gases like helium, argon, neon, etc. All these kinds of elements are having only one atom in their molecule. So they are monoatomic in nature. Most of the metals and noble gases are having only one atom present in their molecule. So their atomicity is one. Now, the next we are having diatomic. Di means how many? Two. It means The molecule of the same element in which two atoms combine together. For example, H2, N2, O2, Br2, that is bromine, Cl2, chlorine. In these example, as you can see, two atoms of these elements combine together. So their atomicity is 2. The next we are having triatomic. Tri means how many? 3 atoms. Yes. For example, ozone. In ozone, 3 atoms of oxygen combine together to form 1 molecule of ozone. Tetra. Tetra means 4. It means 4 atoms. So here we are having example phosphorus. Phosphorus always exists as P4, in which 4 atoms of phosphorus chemically combine together. Then the next and the last category we are having polyatomic. Poly means more than 4 atoms, right? It can be 5, 6, 7 or 8. We are having example here sulfur. Sulfur is having 8 atoms combined together chemically, right? And existing as S8, fine? I hope you have understood how the molecules of elements are formed. The next we are having molecules of compound. The molecules of compounds are formed when the two or more than two atoms of different elements combine together chemically. As you can see from the following example, NH3, ammonia. Here, one atom of nitrogen combined with 3 atoms of hydrogen. Here, in HCl, hydrochloric acid. Here, one atom of hydrogen is combined with one atom of chlorine. Water. Two atoms of hydrogen combined with one atom of oxygen. One atom of carbon combined with two atoms of oxygen. When the atoms of different elements combine together, as you can see in the following example, we are having different examples also. The molecules of compounds are formed. As we know that every atom normally contains equal number of negative and positive charge particles, which balance the overall charge of an atom, and it considered as electrically neutral. But when we talk about ions, they are formed when any atom lose or gain the number of electrons. So, ion is of two types. The first one is positive charge ion, which is known as cation, which is formed by the loss of one or more than one electron by an atom. It is having positive charge because in cation, the number of negative charge particles are less as compared to number of positive charge particles. The second type of ion is negatively charged ion, which is known as anion. An anion is formed by the gain of one or more electron by the atom. As we know that anion contains more number of electrons than positive charge particles, so the overall charge on anion is negative charge. Hopefully you have understood today's topic. So please do your revision for your semester exams on regular basis. But don't forget to like my video and subscribe my channel. Have a nice day ahead.